Welcome to the overview of the Component Tracking Program. The Component Tracking Program provides significant data enhancements for the rail industry related to the safety and operation of components on equipment. It is important that all stakeholders understand requirements for the overall success of this multi-year program. In this presentation, we'll cover three key areas: objectives of the program, timelines, and where to find additional information. Over time, the industry has identified performance issues with components related to manufacture, application, and operation of components. In these cases, limited information has resulted in time-consuming and costly inspection and replacement of many components to ensure that defective components are replaced. Next, let's take a look at the cost of defects. For injury and damage, reducing these costs is the primary objective. For delays, even minor derailments and failure can cause operational delays. Inspection: major defects can require physical inspection of a large portion of the fleet to identify if issues exist. And then for repair, replacement of defects includes component cost, shop time, as well as lost service time for equipment. Here are two of the primary system benefits. First, the ability to quickly identify all registered components matching specified defect criteria, and the ability to identify equipment with defective components applied. Some of the secondary benefits include efficiency and data quality. This includes reduced data entry time by utilizing barcodes, and barcoding standards improve accuracy of data reporting. And there's a potential to automate data entry involved in billing for repairs. Another benefit is identifying defects. Analysis of component data can identify trends that highlight an issue with the manufacture, assembly, or operation of a component. And another benefit is the data from components are valuable to create benchmarking and analysis, such as the expected life of a wheel set in certain service or the mean time to failure once a wheel set begins to generate alerts. Railinc finalized the major system functionality to support component tracking in October of 2011. Beginning in February 2012, manufacturers began to place new standard barcodes on components. These barcodes contain detailed information regarding the specifications of the wheel, axle, or bearing. By July 2012, all wheel shops began to utilize these barcodes to gather the details of wheels, axles, and bearings that are assembled into a single wheel set. The wheel shops apply a unique AAR component identifier to each wheel set at that time and report the details related to the assembled wheel set to Railinc. By January 2013, repair shops and equipment builders began to use this new AAR component ID to report the association of each unique wheel set to equipment. Once association is recorded, the information is kept confidential and is made available for parties having cause to access the information with the appropriate approvals. In addition to implementing standards for wheel sets, we've also implemented standards for side frames, bolsters, couplers, slack adjusters, brake valves, pressure relief valves, and cushioning units. Additional phases are being deployed. Additional information regarding the component tracking program is available at public.railinc.com/products-services/component-tracking. That wraps up this brief overview about the component tracking program. Contact us for more information.